This is a story of a 16-year-old high school boy who is a very strong fighter and arrogant as well. But his life drastically changes when he finds a demon lord baby. The high schooler's name is Oga Tatsumi and he is engaging in a fight against a big bully at the school. Just as they were starting to fight, people gathered around them notice that Oga has a small baby on his head. The bully starts laughing and mocks Oga. He picks up the baby from his head and looks at the baby. The baby starts crying. His crying conjures up lightning and shocks everyone with electric current. Sometime later, Oga is seen talking with his friend Furaki. He is telling Furaki a story about how while he was beating up some bullies by the stream, a big unknown man came flowing down the stream. Everyone become afraid and run away from the stream except Oga. Instead, Oga picks up the man from the stream and throws him on the ground. The man separates apart from middle and out of him a baby comes out. We learn that the baby's name is Beelzebub. After Beelzebub comes out, the man dives back in the stream. Oga looks at Beelzebub and gets confused. He tries to scare the baby by making different funny and scary faces. But instead of being afraid, Beelzebub loves it and jumps off at Oga and has been sticking with him since. Next day at school, Oga and Furaki are walking down the hallway. Oga is worried of Beelzebub crying and is trying his best to keep him from crying. While they are walking, two guys come out arguing from their class. Oga tells them to stop arguing and grabs them by their necks. Seeing the commotion, Beelzebub starts crying, shocking both Oga and the guys with his lightning. Oga is tired of Beelzebub's antics and tries to find out Beelzebub's origins with Furaki. Beelzebub is about to cry again, so Oga asks Furaki to do something to calm down the baby. Furaki draws a cartoon character and shows it to the baby, but the baby doesn't like his drawing. Furaki then gives him a teddy which he brought for his date, but Beelzebub throws it out of the window. None of their tricks work and Beelzebub again shocks both Oga and Furaki by his lightning. Later after school, Oga goes to Furaki's house. He wants to find ways so he can get rid of the baby. Furaki tells him that he can't stay at his house for long because he has to go on a date. Oga suggests Furaki to take the baby with him and raise him together with him. But Furaki coldly rejects the offer as he doesn't want to get lightning shock for the rest of his life. While they are arguing what to do with the baby, a blonde girl in a maid costume appears in their room through the window on a flying umbrella. She tells them that her name is Hilda and reveals that Beelzebub is not an ordinary baby, but he is a child of a powerful demon lord. She mocks them and says that low-life humans like Oga and Furaki are not worthy of taking care of Beelzebub and tries to snatch the baby from Oga. But Beelzebub has grown so attached to Oga that he doesn't let go of him. Hilda tries again, but Beelzebub starts crying, shocking all of them with lightning. Hilda then admits defeat and reveals that Beelzebub was actually sent to destroy the human race from the earth. Hearing Hilda's words, Oga and Furaki are shocked at how a small baby like Beelzebub is able to wipe out the human race. Seeing their doubts, Hilda reveals them that father of Beelzebub, the demon king, is very lazy. He is more interested in useless matters and isn't interested in destroying the earth, so he sent his son to finish his job. The baby will live with humans and after he has grown up, he will proceed to destroy humans' race. Oga thinks all of this is nonsense and tells Hilda that he doesn't have time for babysitting. Hilda threatens them that she will kill them if they refuse. Oga and Furaki both are scared and runs out of Furaki's house while Beelzebub is clinging on Oga's back. Hilda teleports in front of them saying they can't escape her, and summons a demon guard creature to stop them, but Oga kicks the creature and knocks it unconscious. Hilda catches up and takes out her sword and scratches Oga's face with it. A drop of Oga's blood falls on Beelzebub's cheeks. Seeing Oga hurt, Beelzebub starts crying louder than ever and all of them get shocked. But despite getting shocked, Oga is seen calming, sitting and patting Beelzebub, telling him that he shouldn't cry over little things because others will think he is weak. After calming down Beelzebub, Oga leaves Beelzebub on the ground and starts walking away. As he is walking away, electric poles broken by Beelzebub's crying earlier starts falling towards Beelzebub. Oga rushes towards him and pick up Beelzebub just in time. As the steel poles are falling down on them, Beelzebub conjures up extreme heat, melting the poles and knocking Oga unconscious. Oga finally wakes up after 2 days in his room. He thinks he was just having a bad dream, but as he turns to his right, he finds Hilda sitting here holding Beelzebub. Hilda tells him from that day, Oga will act as Beelzebub's father and raise him in his house. Hilda introduces herself to Oga's family. His family thinks Hilda is his girlfriend. Hilda tells Oga from now on she is also staying at his house so that she can keep watch at how Oga behaves with Beelzebub. Also, if Oga is more than 15 meters away from Beelzebub, he can get life-threatening electric shock. Next day at school, some guys snatch Beelzebub away from Oga to irritate him. Oga remembers Hilda's warning and warns them to return Beelzebub back. Just as he was dealing with those guys, Two twin brothers named Sonata twins arrive at the scene. They challenge Oga for a fight, but Oga defeats both of them in just one punch. Later that day, Belzbub is sleeping soundly as he is very tired after crying all day. Suddenly the same big man from earlier appears at Oga's room. We learn his name is Alenda Lon. This time out of his body, Furacy comes out and asks Oga how is Belzbub. Oga shows him the sleeping baby. Furacy and Oga is still in doubt how this small baby has power to destroy the world. Hilda explains them that as Belzbub will grow up, he will gain immense power and become very powerful. Oga inquires Alenda Lon why he chose Oga to care for Belzbub out of all people. Alenda Lon explains the reason he chose Oga was his toughness. Furacy suggests that if they find a more tougher guy than Oga, maybe Belzbub would leave Oga. Next we are shown the demon realm, where demons are playing some kind of gambling game. The demon lord orders his servant to deliver Belzbub's favorite toy to Oga. Next day at school, Oga is searching for a rougher guy than him but doesn't find any. Hilda also comes to the school with Belzbub's toy. She can't find Oga, so she goes to Furacy and asks where is Oga. A troublesome guy enters and tries to harass Hilda, so she kicks him out of the window. Scared of Hilda, everybody runs out of the hallway. Seeing everybody running, Oga thinks he finally found a tough guy, but it's just Hilda. Hilda hands the toy to Belzbub, who becomes very happy seeing his favorite toy. While walking down the hallway, Oga realizes that only one person can be more tougher than him in the entire school, the school's principal. He goes to the principal's office but is disappointed to find that the principal is the weakest in the entire school. Belzbub again starts crying, and frustrated Oga asks Hilda what he wants now. Hilda deduces that Belzbub is hungry, so they go to the canteen to get some milk for him. When Belzbub is about to drink his milk, two guys fighting over sandwich knocks his milk out of his hand. Belzbub gets super upset and cries, collapsing half of the canteen building. Later in the evening, Oga is seen with Belzbub sitting across a river. He is seen telling Belzbub to be strong and stop crying so much all the time. He tells him that people will say he is weak and disrespect him. Instead, he should try to be stronger so he can face challenges when he grows up. Just as Oga was finished talking, the Sonata twins arrive there on bike and snatches Belzbub away. Oga runs after them, trying to maintain his distance of 15 meters. As he chasing those twins, Alandian appears beside him and teleports Oga in front of the twins' bike. The twins crash the bike. Oga picks up Belzbub and puts him on his head. Then both Oga and Belzbub conjures up a firepower and punches the twins, throwing them far in the sky. Hilda is then watching them from afar and notes that Og is doing a great job. Like, comment and subscribe for more awesome anime recap videos. Thanks for watching.